My dear friends, there are 52 Fridays in a year, but only one Friday is called the Good Friday. Humanly speaking, can we call this as a Good Friday? What is the good about this Friday? What does the celebration of Good Friday mean for the Christians? What does it mean for the whole humanity today? Good Friday is the commemoration of the day when Christ was crucified and killed at Calvary more than 2,000 years ago. This day begins with the betrayal of the teacher by his own disciples and ends with the death of an innocent. On this day, a man is sold for money, and filial sign of a kiss is hypocritically used for the betrayal. On this day, people disown their own, and the only son is killed in front of his mother. The judge, like Pontius Pilate, whose duty was to discern the truth and denounce injustice, on that day condemns to death an innocent person. Against his own conviction, in spite of good counsel by his wife, under pressure from the crowd. If such a day is called good, will there be any bad day or a bad Friday left in a year? Other days should be better than such a day. Are we to celebrate such betrayal, disowning, unjust judgment, and the so-called Praja Court? Is there anything good to remember, to celebrate? Purely from the human point of view, the day has all that we experience as bad, painful, and hopeless. What all things people did to Jesus on that day is truly bad. And by narrating all that, we can only find ourselves among them. The religious leaders, the political leaders, the judges, the bureaucrats, and the soldiers. And maybe end up with condemning ourselves. But everything that Jesus did is good, and only good things. He proved that He did not come to condemn the world, you and me, but to save us. Let us now turn our attention to the good things that happened on that day, to the good things Jesus did to the humanity. Those who do wrong under pressure, passion, or various temptations, and don't do the good due to various pulls and pressures from within or without. Those who do wrong things more out of ignorance than from bad intentions. Those feel themselves hopeless as they don't get justice or feel ashamed due to their own guilt, and life becomes unbearable and death seems to be the only way. Jesus stood for the truth and for what He was, the Son of Man. He did not bow to the temptations to take any easy way to come down from the cross to fulfill His mission. Jesus was kind to Judas as He betrayed him with a kiss. He did not allow violence for self-protection, and His merciful look at Peter was enough to wipe away Peter's guilt of betrayal. He consoled the women who were crying for Him and encouraged them against the impending suffering of their children. He rewarded persons for their kindness, gave His own mother to be the mother of His disciples by praying for those who killed Him because of their ignorance He prayed for us all, as we often do the wrong out of ignorance. He even promised to fulfill the prayer of the thief who was crucified with him. He, in humility, accepted his guilt and prayed for the remembrance of Jesus. Jesus was truly human, understanding all human weaknesses, and truly God, mercifully accepting us as his brothers and sisters. He is never ashamed to call us brothers and sisters. Why should we, to our fellow human beings, the tribals, the Dalits? He showed the way to the fulfillment of all our hopes and aspirations, to persevere till the end without losing hope and surrendering everything to God the Father. "Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit," he said. Christians believe that Jesus saved humanity by sacrificing himself on the cross, and God the Father raised him up on the third day, on the Easter Sunday. If the Good Friday is here, will the Easter Sunday be far off? In his wounds, in his death, human beings regain the divine life that was lost by sin. Thus, even amidst the bad events of the Good Friday, God brings out the good. He has the power to turn everything into good, even out of so-called the bad things, into good for those who love him. May the crucified Lord bless you with peace and joy of the Easter.